You still remember the old BMW M57? Well, if you think they are dead, they are definitely not. Because for today, we have one here in the shop for a stage 3 setup, but before we start, we'll put it first on a dyno to see if it still makes stock figures. I think it should deliver just what it should from factory, so let's have a look. The car makes solid numbers, still stock figures. Also, we measured the car multiple times, and run after run, the numbers were just repetitive. This should make 500 newton. It has a little bit more, 529 and normally 231, and it makes 232. But that's not such a big surprise, knowing that he has only 110,000 kilometers. We'll put it in the workshop, pull some parts of the car, and then you can compare the new parts to the old parts to see the size difference, and from there you can start upgrading the parts to the newer ones. Quick rundown on the setup for this car. We have a turbo systems, a hybrid turbo, the stage 2 ball bearing variant. There are like 4 different versions of this turbo. You have the stage 2, stage 2. No, actually 5. You have the stage 2, stage 2 ball bearing, stage 3 ball bearing, stage 4 ball bearing, and stage 5 ball bearing. This client didn't want too much of power gains. He just want fast car, which is reliable, which is quite stable temperature wise, and which he can push hard. But his main goal was never to achieve massive numbers. Even the stage 2 ball bearing is a lot bigger than the original one. If we compare it, we'll see we have a bigger exhaust wheel and also a bigger compressor wheel as well. Have a look. So you see the difference. Even as this is the smallest size they produce, it's still a big turbo. And because of the ball bearing, it will still remain very punchy and low end and still deliver a little bit more top end. For the intercooler, we've chosen for the Wagner Evo 1 because you can also go bigger to Evo 2 or Evo 3. It's advisable to not mount in too big of an intercooler because a bigger intercooler means also a little bit more turbo lag because it takes more time to fill the volume of the intercooler. But even if you compare those, you can see it's a quite noticeable size difference. So that will be sufficient for the power goal we set. For the downpipe, bigger is almost always better, but because this client doesn't want that the car makes too much noise and he keeps the original exhaust system, it is not big of an upgrade to put on an even bigger downpipe. Besides those things, we just mount a gear delete and then we have our custom software that we will make here on the dyno. What we still need to do is a quick rundown on the total cost of the setup. We have the turbo, 1270 euros, intercooler, 500 euros, downpipe, 300 euros, gear delete, 115 euros. Then we have still mounting and the software itself. All the parts are installed, so that means you can start on the software. First, we're gonna check if the car is on the latest software level. If that's the case, then you can pull out the original file and start making a base file from there. If not, we're gonna do a software update first and then pull out the original software, make a base map and put it on the line. If interested, we can also do remote tuning and deliver you the correct parts or also talk about the correct setup for this specific car. Just give us a quick message and I'll drop some interesting links in the comment. The car is strapped and ready to test. It's currently writing the base file, which we'll test first. We made the mild tune just to see how the car reacts, how boost behaves, how the actuator of the turbo needs to be altered. And from there, we can work a bit more on the tunes, see what the clutch likes because it's a manual gearbox. Our first run was a good starting point. We made around 330 HP and 719 Nm of torque. Torque is more than enough. That's what the target was for the client, so we're happy with that. But on the higher rev range, we had some issues with valve float, so I needed to alter the boost a little bit, which I did now as well. Besides the boost, we altered also a little bit of fueling and added some timing to the start of the injection. Car is ready to test now again, but first I have to run a little bit to get it a little bit hotter, and then you can wait in second run to see how he behaves. V2 was a little bit better than V1, we gained some top end, also have a little bit more spool. If we look to the graph, we can see we gained approximately 15 HP. It also pulls a little bit farther, but we still have some issues with valve float now a little bit later in the rev range. So we lowered the boost in the higher revs another bit. If you look here on the graph, you can see we almost gained around 100 RPMs of spool as well, which is a good gain. Also, if you have a look in the data log, we can see lambda is quite okay. We have still lots of air only on top. Little bit on the ridge side, but still no drama. Boost is quite stable as well. It gets on full boost, let's say around something like 2300 RPMs, which is quite good for the bigger turbo. Rail pressure also stable and on point. You see also no weird things in the actuation of the pump, so that means that we're not reach the limit of the fuel pump as well, because in this case we still use the stock R70 fuel pump, so we know that's a restricting factor. That's also one of the things why we stop at around 800 newtons, and of course also because the client don't want too much more torque than 800 newtons. Currently V3 is flashing with a little bit less boost on top, so let's have a look if the car likes it or not. That's not too bad. So we made 796 newtons and 348 HP. Yeah, you can see the boost taper a bit on top as well. Let's have a look to the data. Boost is quite controlled and stable, nothing to say about. We have 588 degrees Celsius in the downpipe at the end of the run, which is quite low as well. Lambda 110-109. Right before the limiter, so that's also not too smoky. Fuel pump has still some room as well, so not limited. Even when it spools and it gets on torque, just quite stable, rail pressure stable. This is, let's say, good base. We have around, yeah, let's say 1100 kilograms of air per hour, so that's not too bad for a turbo like this. After a quick call with the client, we decided to leave the car as it is now. There are some bottlenecks on the setup, and that's something that we knew before. We are limited by the stock exhaust system because it has a small diameter. Also, we don't have valve springs, and also we still have the original high pressure fuel pump and the original rail pressure sensor. So we knew it was a little bit of a bottleneck, but considering the target that the client had in mind, it was not a big issue to finish the car like this.